The man who would become Padre Pio was born in Pietrelcina in the Archdiocese of Benevento, Italy, about an hour and 15 minutes by vehicle from Naples, on the 25th of May, 1887. His given name was Francesco Forgione. His parents were Grazio Forgione and Maria Giuseppa D'Annunzio. As a boy, Francesco discerned a call to religious life. In 1903, he became a novice with the Capuchins, and in 1910, he was ordained a priest. As a Capuchin friar, Francesco adopted the name Pius, or in Italian, Pio. Though his life might otherwise have been spent quietly ministering to the poor, hearing confessions, and celebrating the Mass, Padre Pio was pushed into the spotlight through his mystical experiences and the appearance of his stigmata, the first time such a miracle had happened to a priest. In 1911, Padre Pio wrote to a friend, "Last night something happened which I can neither explain nor understand. In the middle of the palms of my hands a red mark appeared, about the size of a penny, accompanied by acute pain in the middle of the red marks. The pain was more pronounced in the middle of the left hand, so much that I can still feel it. Also under my feet I can feel some pain." Furthermore, at the request of Father Agostino Gemelli, Padre Pio further described having had celestial visions. Troubled by the appearance of the stigmata, Padre Pio prayed to God to remove it. Obligingly, the marks disappeared for several years, though not the pain associated with them. The stigmata's appearance brought many crowds throughout Pio's life, but it also brought authorities in the Vatican who had concerns about the legitimacy of Padre Pio's mystical experiences, including whether or not his wounds were self-inflicted. But through many tests and trials over many years, these concerns would be alleviated. In 1921, for instance, it was observed that the wounds on Padre Pio's hands were not holes, but sores with blood exuding through his skin. But Padre Pio was not only known for the miraculous occurrences which happened in his own life, but also for the miracles which were attributed to him. In particular, the waking of a comatose 11-year-old and the healing of a woman with a lung disease, which collectively led to his canonization. He was also known as a great confessor, celebrant of the Mass, and minister to the people. 3 years after Padre Pio's death in 1971, Paul VI proclaimed that the reason for Pio's renown was because he said Mass humbly, heard confessions from dawn to dusk, and was, it is not easy to say, one who bore the wounds of our Lord. He was a man of prayer and suffering. Easily one of the most famous saints of the 20th century, Padre Pio stands as a testament to Christian and Franciscan virtue, as well as humble obedience in the face of opposition. Saint Pio of Pietrelcina, ora pro nobis.